Father Luis, welcome to the Armenian Congregational Church. We welcome you on this Palm Sunday to worship the Lord together. We're glad you can join us online. Ողջունեմ ձեզ Տեր Իսուս Քրիստոսի անունով. Գուզեմ որ միասին այսօր դերը բաշխենք եւ հարավորենք իր անունը. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Before we start worshiping, I want to make a few quick announcements for you. First, to remind you that you can watch online the Sunday school. This is for your children. It's not available. It is available at accdetroit.org. Under online service page, we encourage parents to sit down with their children and watch the video lessons and do the accompanied material found below the video. Second, we want to remind you that we are still holding our weekly Bible studies every week online using Google Hangouts Meet app. And we have them on Mondays at 6:30. That's our prayer and fellowship. So we encourage you all to join us. Wednesdays is the Bible study and fellowship, and we do prayer also. And now we have even every Thursday, the young adults also meet from 7 to 8. So if you haven't participated to any of these or you'd like to participate, please RSVP to office@accdetroit.org. That way you get connected and you can join us through any of these services. But you would need to indicate for each of the services which ones you want to be included in. So indicate that, please. And of course, as always, we are encouraging you to spread the word so that those who are not aware, they can join us online for these all of these services. Finally, we'd love to get suggestions and feedbacks from you for our services, and you can do that by emailing to us at office@accdetroit.org. Now, this concludes our announcements. Please join us now at home as we sing our first hymn together, All Worship the King. Enjoyed that beautiful song that we sang together. And now we are going to move forward to do the invocation prayer together. And so if you're ready, let's all join together and say this invocation. Dear Lord, we come this morning in your presence to give you thanks for being good to us. On this Palm Sunday, we celebrate and are reminded that you are the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. You are also our refuge and fortress in times of troubles. We ask you to continue to protect us from this coronavirus and other harms. We know that you love us and only want what is good for us. We pray for all those affected by this virus, that you would be with them and that you would heal them. We pray for their families of those who lost their loved ones due to this virus, that you would comfort them, Lord. We also pray for those whose jobs have been affected, that you would help them financially. We pray for those doctors and nurses who are working so hard to save lives, Lord. Lord God, please hear our prayer and have mercy on your people. We give you all the honor and the praise who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Now I want us to move forward as I will be praying for our congregation, for the world, everything that's going on. I just want to say that if you do have prayer requests, you can send your prayer request for next Sunday's pastoral prayer to pastorhagop@accdetroit.org. Now, with that said, let us bow our heads and pray together. Երկնավոր հարկեզի փառք ու դանք ամբողջ սրտով այս գեղեցիկ օրվա համար Տեր, որ կարող ենք քեզի միասին բաշտել։ Հայր, գաղութեմ քո օրհնությունդ մեր վրա այս արավոտ։ Տեր, գխնդրեմ քո արատ օրհնությունդ թափես մեր բոլորի վրա։ Քո գարիքդ ունինք այսօր, ով Տեր, գաղագենք քո սուրբ անունդ։ Գխնդրենք, որ մեզ հետ ելաս, ով Տեր, աստիճվար օրերուն մեջ ողորմե մեզի, ով Աստվածիմ, ողորմե եւ օրհնեմ ես։ Heavenly Father, we thank you for this wonderful day of Palm Sunday, the day when you entered into Jerusalem as a king, as the king of the Jews. You entered Jerusalem not on a horse as a warrior, but on a donkey as a humble king. And Lord, you also entered into our hearts when we accepted you as king and Lord of our own lives, O Lord. We thank you, Father, that we can come together this morning to worship you as our King, as our Lord. And Lord, we lift up all of our concerns to you. But we want to honor first your holy name before we bring our concerns. We know you are holy and just and loving. And with all that is happening, Lord, in our world, with this pandemic virus, Father, I pray that your peace would still rule and dwell in our hearts and our minds, and that we may be remembered that you are still sitting on your throne, and Lord, you're still sovereign and rule over the universe. And we pray that you would also rule on our hearts. Father, I want to lift up to you some of our church members who are suffering, that you would continue to be with them. We hike Arabian, Lord, that you would comfort him and be with him in these difficult days as he spends a lot of hours alone. I also want to pray for Susan and Glenn Harrison, that you would bless them and continue to bless Glenn, Lord, for his well-being. I pray for Alice Masilo, and Lord, you know her needs, you know she's weak. She needs your presence, she needs your strength. I pray for Carol Basmajian, who Lord needs your help as she injured herself and she's in a lot of pain. I pray that you would comfort her, Lord, that you would be with her and that you would heal her quickly, Lord, and she would be healed and that she would continue to worship you, Lord, and magnify your name, Lord. Lord, we have all these prayers and we have so many other more, but we lift them all up to you, Lord, and we ask that you would answer us, Father. We plead with you for this virus to go away, Lord, to be taken away once and for all. Have mercy, Lord. Have mercy on us. Forgive us for our sins, Lord. Cleanse us, O Lord, and heal the land, O Lord. Heal this world from this pain, Lord, from this loss, from this suffering. We thank you for all these things, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Next, I want us to move forward with our offering. Offering is a way of worship. And I want you to know that as we've been mentioning last Sunday, we mentioned that you can send your offerings directly to our church address, to the church. But we're also excited to say that now we are going to be having the option to give our offerings online. And so you can do so by going to our website at accdetroit.org and just click on donate. You can make sure that your offerings are going to be by credit card and they're in a secure manner. I want us to pray for the offerings and give thanks to the Lord for that. Father, we come to you again. We just pray that you would bless these offerings being offered to you as a pleasing aroma to you, O Lord. They come from our heart, and we ask that you would bless those who give, Lord, and that you bless that these offerings would be used only for your kingdom, Lord, to spread your word. And so we thank you for them in Jesus' name. Amen. Next, I want us to read the Apostles' Creed. As we do this every week, we are reminded that we stand on a solid rock, and that rock is Jesus Christ himself. And so with that, let us please prepare our hearts and confess this great confession that we belong to our God. And so let's say it together. I believe in God the Father, Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Now we're going to transition to our second song, and I want us again, all of you, to join. If you like to stand up, you may, and we're going to sing together our next hymn called All Creatures of Our God and King. I hope you enjoyed the wonderful song we just had together, All Creatures of Our God and King. With that, we're going to transition into our sermon. And today, being that it's Palm Sunday, I want to say happy Palm Sunday. This is a significant Sunday because it signifies as Jesus entering into Jerusalem as the King of the Jews. He intentionally and willingly decided to enter Jerusalem as king, as a conqueror, but not as a king as usually traditionally they enter into their capital city. Usually kings would enter with horses and chariots. Jesus chose to enter with donkey. That signifies the humility of his heart. And we constantly see the heart of Jesus being so humble. In Luke, I want us to look at the passage of how Jesus comes into Jerusalem and what kind of reaction he gets from the people. Now, I want you to notice that the same people who are going to be praising him, Hosanna, praising him and giving thanks to him for being king and lifting his name up, some of them, if not all of them, a few days later, they're going to cry out, crucify him. This is why it's important that we worship the Lord from the heart, not just with our lips. I want to read the passage and just sit back, relax, reflect on what I'm about to read. This is God's word, so let's listen to it. Luke says in 19, after Jesus had said this, he went ahead and going to Jerusalem, as he approached Bethany at the hill called the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples, saying to them, go to the village ahead of you, and as you enter it, you will find a colt tied there, which no one has ridden. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone asks you, why are you untying it, say, the Lord needs it. Those who were sent ahead went and found just as he told them. Here we go. Here's another miracle. As they were untying the colt, its owner asked them, why are you untying it? They replied, the Lord needs it. They brought it to Jesus, threw their cloaks on the colt and put Jesus on it. As he went along, people spread their cloaks on the road. And in John it says branches. This is why we traditionally have branches. When he came near the place where the road goes down to Mount of Olives, the whole crowds of disciples began joyfully to praise God in loud voices for all the miracles they had seen. And this is what they shouted. Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace on earth and glory in the highest. Some of the Pharisees in the crowd said to Jesus, teacher, rebuke your disciples. And Jesus answered them, I tell you, if they keep quiet, the stones will cry out. Brothers and sisters, we cannot be quiet. The King has come. The King has conquered. The King has given his life for his sheep. We cannot be silent. If we are silent to worship the Lord, to adore him, to honor him as King, guess what? Jesus says he'll make the stones become human beings and they will worship him. Somebody has to worship him because he is worthy. If we don't, he will choose other things, other people. It's such an honor to be the children of the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. What is there to be ashamed of? Jesus said, if anyone is ashamed of me, the Son of Man will be ashamed of him on his return. A lot of people don't want to acknowledge Christ as the Lord and Savior for various reasons. Shameful, living in the world and its pleasure. They know that their conscience would be stricken with all the pleasure and the idols they worship, so they'd rather not confess that or accept it. Most of us would rather just live for ourselves. We don't want no king to rule over our heart, our lives. We like to be free. We like to do things the way we want it. But we forget that without our Creator and our King, we are utterly lost. Now, the first time Jesus came with a heart of humility on a donkey. The second time, the Bible tells us, he's not going to be the same. I'm going to read a couple of passages for you that when he comes back again, second time, as King and as Lord, he's not coming on a donkey. He's coming on a white horse, as a warrior, as a judge, as a conqueror. Here is what Revelation says. Then 10 horns you saw are the kings whom you have not received a kingdom yet, but who for 1 hour will receive authority as kings along with the beast. They have one purpose and will give their power and authority to the beast. They will wage war against the Lamb. That's Christ. But the Lamb will triumph over them because he is Lord of Lords and King of Kings. And with him will be his called, his faithful ones. That's us, if we remain faithful. Chosen and faithful followers. I want to read another passage for you, and then we'll reflect on this. I saw, this is John the Apostle writing about the second coming of Christ. I saw heaven standing open, and there before me was a white horse, whose rider is called Faithful and True. With justice he judges and wages war. His eyes are like blazing fire, and on his head are many crowns. You know there's so many crowns on Jesus? Because he was victorious over Satan. He crushed his head on the cross and resurrected. He is dressed in a robe dipped in blood, and his name is the Word of God. Jesus is dipped in blood. He's depicted as this man who died on the cross as the Lamb, and he is seen as one who is dipped in blood. Why? Because of our sins. It says the armies of heaven were following him. That's us. We are the army of God. It says they were dressed in fine linen, white and clean. If we're going to follow this king, our dress has to be filled with righteousness, our conduct, our life. And it says they were white and clean. It symbolizes the purity of our walk and life with Christ. It says coming out of his mouth is a sharp sword with which he strikes down the nations. The first time when he came as king, he allowed him to crucify him. That's not what's going to happen the next time. He will strike the nations. He will judge them, those who oppose him. It says he will rule with an iron scepter. He treads the winepress of the fury of the wrath of God Almighty. On his robe and on his high thigh, he has this name written. And guess what it is? That's right. King of kings and Lord of lords. A lot of us, a lot of kings, a lot of people dishonor this king. But a day will come when every king, every person will kneel before Christ on his second return, and they will confess that he is Lord and the King of all creation. But God is calling us to repent. Now, I don't know why we have this virus going on nowadays. Only God knows. All I know is we need God's mercy. And if it takes for us to repent from our sins so that God would come and heal us, then that's what we need to do. Here's a continuation of what I'm reading. It says, then I saw the beast and the kings of the earth and the armies gathered together to wage war against the rider of the white horse and his army. In the last days, there's going to be this war where non-believers with the Antichrist will be fighting against the king, which is Christ, and his followers. That's us. And here's what it says. But the beast was captured, and with it the false prophet. The beast is the Antichrist. And the false prophet's prophet is his right hand, this person who's going to promote his kingship. It says that the beast was captured, and with it the false prophet who performed signs on its behalf. Imagine, through the power of Satan, this prophet is going to perform signs so people would believe in Antichrist. With these signs, he had deluded those who had received the mark of the beast and worshiped its image. The two of them were thrown alive into the fiery lake of burning sulfur. That's hell. Satan, his prophet, the Antichrist, all thrown into the lake of fire. That's the final judgment. The rest of who were killed with the sword coming out of the mouth of the rider on the horse, and all the birds gorged them on their flesh. Basically, what I'm trying to say here is, or God's word is trying to teach us, is that we're living in the last days. We don't know when Christ is coming back, but the signs we're noticing should awaken us and should prepare us to meet the King of kings and Lord of lords. Here's my conclusion to what we learned today. If we don't cry out to the Lord, the stones will. God is calling every flesh, every human being, to call on the name of the Lord, to invite him to be the King and Lord over their heart. Who sits on the center of your heart? What idols are controlling you? What pleasures? The Bible says that the pleasures of the world will pass away, but the person who does the will of God shall live forever. The king has to be enthroned and sit on the throne of our heart. He deserves it. When he rules, when he guides our heart, when he becomes the Lord of our lives, then we'll have this peace. We'll be able to live in peace with him and in fellowship. And ultimately, when he comes again, we won't be judged by him, we will be saved. Sirener, Guzem Selvor, I saw Meng Asbara Kandarimich Gabring. Yevasvats Mezig Ganchevor Iren Hedeving. Մեր թակավորը մեզի գանչե որ իրեն բաշտենք։ Սենը գուզեմ Զեկրայի 9-րդ գլուխին 9-րդ համարը այդպես սկսե գարտամ ցեզի։ Մենզաբես քայդի ով Սիոնի աղջի։ Ցնզուչամ գոչե ով Երուսաղեմի աղջիկ։ Ահա թակավորդ քեզի գուքա, ահա արդարը ու փրկիչ։ Հեզ ու իշու վրա հեզած, իշու ծակի ավանգի վրա։ Սիրեներ, Աստծո խոսքը գսե այդպես. Let me read to you from Zechariah, is what I read in Armenian, about the prophecy of the coming of Jesus as king. Isn't it interesting that even this prophecy was told about Jesus entering into Jerusalem as king? This is what Zechariah writes in 9:9. Rejoice greatly, daughter of Zion. Shout, daughter of Jerusalem. See, your king comes to you, righteous and victorious, lowly and riding on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey. Սիրեն Հիսուս Երուսաղեմ մտավ իշու վրա, քանի որ խոնար սիրտ ունի, ոչ թե ծիի վրա, այլ իշու վրա, քանի որ ինքը խոնար թագավոր է, և գսե աղթական թագավոր է. Brothers and sisters, Jesus entered Jerusalem, it says, with victory. He is righteous and victorious. A lot of the Jews back then assumed that he's going to come and save them from the Roman Empire. He's going to come as a warrior and fight for them. They had missed out that he came to save them from their sins, which mattered more. Սիրեներ, Հիսուս եկավ ոչ թե իր ժողովուրդը Ռոմի իշխանությունից ազատելու, ինչպես որ կգարձեին շատերը, այլ եկավ որպեսզի իրենց մեղքերեն փրկի իրենց և ազատագրե։ Եվ ասված ազատագրեց մեզ, սիրեններ, մեր մեղքերեն, քանի որ իր կյանքը զոհեց խաչի վրա։ Երբ որ խաչին վրան էր, քրվեցավ իր խաչին վրան, ահա Իսրայելի հրյաներուն թագավոր։ When Jesus was crucified, soon after they were singing Hosanna to him, on the cross, they put a sign, and it says, King of the Jews. And later when they asked the soldier, the centurion, why did you put that over there? He's not the king of the Jews. He responded, I did what I did. He doesn't even know exactly why he did it, but God moved him. Because the whole world needed to know that he is the king of the Jews. Սիրեներ, Հիսուս թագավոր է, բայց որքան կեղեցիկ է, որ Հիսուս թագավոր գելա մեր կյանքերու վրա, մեր սիրտերու մեջ. What matters is that Jesus becomes the king of our heart. When that happens, we have the peace of God in our heart. Օրդնյալլա դերոջ անուն է, Օրդնյալլա իր սուրբ անուն է, թող Աստված պարավորվի մեր կյանքով, թող Հիսուս Քրիստոս որպես մեր թագավորը իշխե և դիրե մեր կյանքի վրա։ Brothers and sisters, may this King, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, who is coming very soon to take us home, let him rule over your life, let him guide your life. During this crisis, let him give you the peace you need, as we all do. Սիրեներ, թող Աստծո սերը, Քրիստոսի շնորհքը, և Սուրբ Հոգու արդությունը, ձեր բոլորին հելա, հիմա և այժմ հավիտյանս հավիտենից, ամեն։ May the love of our Father and the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you always. Amen.